Today, we're flying Club World with British Airways aboard the Airbus A380, traveling from London to Miami. Many, including ourselves, have had the pleasure of flying on this type of aircraft several times over the years, and it's always been a comfortable and enjoyable experience. However, having had the chance to experience the new Club Suites multiple times over the past couple of years, I'm now eager to take a fresh look at this older Club World product. So join me as we find out if the experience is still worth the splurge. Hi fellow travellers, it's Ken from Ken Travel 360 here. Today we are back at London Heathrow Terminal 5 and we are flying with BA to Miami in Club World. I'm incredibly excited as we are joining a cruise tomorrow on Royal Caribbean's Icon of the Seas, the newest and the largest cruise ship in the world. It's been over 6 months since I last flew from this terminal, so I'm eager to share my experience today with you guys. Let's go get our bags checked in first. So we just got through security, and because our flight will be departing from gate C64, we'll be visiting the Terminal 5B Galleries Lounge. We're now taking the train to go to the B gates. As always, we had a delightful time in the lounge, indulging in a full English wash down with Prosecco.
Cheers.
I've actually covered our experience of the renovated T5B Galleries Lounge in a separate video, so I won't repeat it here. I'll link it above if you're interested. If you haven't been to this lounge in the past 8 months or so, it's well worth watching it to see all the new enhancements there. Well, we're about to go to the boarding gate, C64, when I noticed the flight has been delayed for 45 minutes. This does worry me a bit. You see, our flight BA207 to Miami is operated by an A380 and has been experiencing quite a few delays and even cancellation on some odd days, much like other A380 routes such as Johannesburg, which is served by BA with the Super Jumbo twice daily. During the COVID pandemic, BA retired all their old Boeing 747s, expecting a slower recovery. However, the unexpectedly high demand post-pandemic has strained their fleet of A380s, leaving little room for error. Any maintenance issues can lead to significant disruptions. Luckily for us, the delay didn't become something worse. Soon, it was time for boarding. We'll head over there now. Right, we have arrived at gate C64. Let's see if we can check out the big bird first. There it is, there's the A380. It's a bit far away, but you can just about see it. We're boarding now. There are two doors, one for the upper deck and one for the lower deck. As our seats are on the upper deck, we'll take the one on the right.
Sitting in a front row seat for an emergency exit row.
Thank you.
Or in our first or public cabins, the floor area must be completely clear for taking luggage safety.
Here's our seats. On the A380s, British Airways has different configurations across its two decks for its Club World cabin. The seats are arranged in a yin-yang configuration, which means half of these face backwards. Just like mine. If you haven't done it before, it may be a novelty. On the lower deck, you'll find Club World configured in a 242 layout, much like the Boeing 777s that haven't been converted to Club Suites yet. The upper deck, being naturally narrower, has a 232 layout in the Club World cabin, which creates a less cramped feeling. Well, I've settled comfortably in my seat 51K on the upper deck, and it's a backward-facing window seat. Now, apart from the more spacious configuration, another reason you should choose a seat on the upper deck, and particularly a window seat, is the presence of these side bins that you've got access to. You do have to step over the person in the aisle seat in front of you, or well, actually behind, depending on your perspective, when getting in and out, but that's only an issue when they have their footstool done. Well, I have to say, the menu doesn't look very exciting today. I think for the starter, I'm gonna go for the carpaccio, beef carpaccio, and for the main course, It's gonna have to be the pork loin. I don't really like curry. But the crew has just come round to deliver a welcome drink. You get the usual choice of orange juice or champagne. Cheers! Right, this is the amenity kit. Let's see what is inside. I bought hundreds of these at home, but still, let's find out what is inside. You get socks and eye shades, and a bunch of toiletries like toothpaste, lip balm, moisturizer. This is a headphone, a noise cancelling headphone. The quality is okay, it's nothing special though. On BA A380 Club World seats, you get a 12-inch touchscreen and it's equipped with lots of choice of movies and TV shows. The seat design is of course a bit dated by now, but it's still very comfortable. You can control it from the side buttons that allows you to adjust the seat to any angle you like. There is a stool at the end of the seat, which connects to the seat itself to form a lie flat bed. Don't sit on it though, it can't support the full weight of a person, and it's not great if it snaps. After what feels like an eternity of taxiing, our plane is finally taking off, bidding farewell to rainy London. If you've been enjoying this video, please give this video a thumbs up. And please consider subscribing to the channel. I've got a lot more travel and flight review contents on my channel. But let's check out the toilet next. BA A380 planes are famous for their oversized toilets in the upper deck. It's so much easier to change into your PJ in a toilet that is that big. After slipping into my PJs, I settled into my seat and indulged in a movie, Barbie of all things. With our busy travel schedule last year, this was actually the first chance we've got to catch it. As I relaxed, snacks and drinks arrived while lunch was being heated up. Before long, the lunch service began. I decided to start with the roast beef carpaccio, and it was rather good. For the main course, I've chosen the Hampshire pork loin. Unfortunately, the meat was disappointingly tough, even though it's tasty. But it's far from the fine dining experience that BA advertised. To wrap up the meal, I treated myself to a classic chocolate bar dessert, and that proved to be a great choice. I stayed awake until the credits rolled on Barbie. Then it's time to turn my seat into a flat bed for a quick nap. Good afternoon. I just had a couple of hours of sleep, which was much needed after the very early start this morning. I was actually woken up by the turbulence. You can really feel it in these seats. There are some other issues with these old Club World seats compared to the new Club Suites. Because your footstool is connected to the seats of the row behind or forward, you could also feel the vibration when those seated there slam the screen or tray table. Finally, these seats feel rather cramped somehow. It's not surprising because they fit the same number of seats in a row as the World Traveler Plus cabin, so you aren't getting any extra seat width. The herringbone design of the new Club Suite is much better. And of course, having to climb over others to get in and out of your seat is a major design issue. I much prefer the individual aisle access that you get with the Club Suites. I've read that BA are planning to install Club Suites on these A380s, but until then, coupled with the unreliability issue, I'll try to avoid booking a flight that is operated by one of these if that is possible. Having said that, I have to add that the service itself is good. We've got a great crew, efficient service, drinks getting topped up, and the lunch itself is of reasonable quality. Well, the afternoon tea service has just arrived. It actually looks pretty good. As we prepare for landing, let me deliver my thoughts. The old club well seats on the A380 have become really dated. The whole aviation world has really moved on in the last few years, and travelers in business class now expect something like the club suites. So I hope BA can really speed up the process of refitting their planes. Of course, it's still very comfortable compared to economy or premium economy. And in our case, we valued the direct flight, so we didn't really have many choices. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. To find out what happened after we land at Miami, watch one of these videos next, where I will show you where we stayed as well as the cruise. See you over there. Ciao.
Welcome to Miami.